Good morning, girl. Bye.
Today's Thursday, March 28th.
And it's day 3.
I'm Malaika.
And I'm Geneva.
And here are your morning announcements. Attention to all grade 9 students. The results for the Cup games are now available.
The Fantastic Five secured third place with 180 points.
The Failures claimed second with 202 points.
Congratulations to the Academic Weapons for getting first place with 220 points.
Academic Weapons, kindly check your emails for details regarding the prize. Big thanks to the Blink crew for organizing this event.
Malaika, how has the whole student trustee thing been going?
Ha, no way you're asking me about this. I coincidentally just recorded an interview.
Whoa.
As you already know, I'm Malaika, and I am one of two OCDSB student trustees. Student trustees are responsible to bring the opinion and voice of the students to the board level. We do that through having a senate, which is composed of two senators per school that represent their schools, obviously, and we meet once a month. The Student Senate, as it is right now, is very new. It is our first year functioning this way. So we spent the first 2 to 3 months just getting comfortable in our shoes. But now that this year has started, we've done a few interesting things. The first thing is that we have a monthly newsletter now. Basically, once a month, you can receive these informations right into your school inbox. Secondly, we've done a lot of consultations. Some of these consultations have included things like AI usage in school, the OCDSB Safe School Reporting Tool, bullying prevention, and identity-based data collections. In addition, as student trustees, we've introduced a motion to send a letter to the ministry about menstrual equity and access to menstrual products in schools. Lastly, we've contributed to establishing two equity coaches that are either Muslim, Arab-speaking, Arab, or Palestinian. We've also already elected our three incoming student trustees, and we have a new position with one of them being an Indigenous student trustee. If you want to learn more about this, once again, make sure to check your inbox once a month for your monthly newsletter. Also, follow our Instagram with that handle. Thanks for tuning in, Cougars. Sending it back to myself.
If you're a graduating student, listen up. It's time to order your commencement gown and pay the commencement fee. The deadline to do so is March 29th. Remember to process the fee through School Cash Online and indicate your gown size on the shared form on the CB homepage.
We have very exciting news. CB Oscars 2024 is now on the way. The first round of voting is open, featuring various categories for both junior and senior students.
Check your school email to cast your vote, as the first round ends this Monday. Get ready for the annual semi-formal Oscars dance on April 26th, where Oscar trophies will be presented.
Our Thursday crew was also nice enough to make a visual. Look at this. Joining either the junior girls soccer team or the senior girls soccer team this year at CB, attend the interest meeting at the start of lunch today in room 207. For any inquiries, feel free to reach out to Mr. Cook or Ms. Connors.
Attention to all students registered for the Euclid Math Contest. Please assemble at the Learning Commons on Wednesday, April 3rd at 9:10 a.m. Geneva, they're checking you. What are you doing with this mic?
I really don't know. Might as well just pass it to the Cougar Vision Show that never hands in their show on time.
I'm passing the microphone to the most irrelevant show on Cougar Vision.
I'm passing the mic to the show that always changes their host.
I'm passing the mic to someone who's so old their yearbook photo is a keyframe drawing.
I'm giving it to someone who thinks America really is great again.
And I'm passing it back to two people who think that their thoughts are more important than mine.
Okay, why is it back here?
I don't know.
Okay, whatever. Time for the Thursday Thought.
This week's Thursday Thought is See You Again by Tyler, the Creator and Hallie Uchi. The song talks about how the narrator's eyes are always searching for their love that lives in their dreams and only surfaces in their mind while they're sleeping.
Ultimately, it encourages listeners to not waste time and to make the most of the moments that they are able to spend with those they cherish.
To all you Cougars who wish to have their Thursday thoughts on Thursday show, then be sure to send your suggestions to cbthursday24@gmail.com, or you can also DM Geneva here on Instagram with her handle down below.
And that's all from us today, CB. Have a televised Thursday. Close my eyes.